and adoption friends. My name is Lauren and this channel is called Lauren Fosters. And today we're gonna talk all about home studies and licensing walkthroughs. As always, I like to introduce myself a little bit, especially if you're tuning in for the first time. I have 10 awesome kids. I'm a foster mom, I'm an adoptive mom. I'm also former foster youth myself, and also I'm military, and I bring that up in a lot of my videos because some of the information I give out might be very state specific or even county specific, and this video is no different. So I want you to know that we have fostered in 3 separate states, which means 3 separate counties and 3 separate set of rules. So let's get started. So what is a home study? A home study is going to likely have a home study writer. Sometimes they work directly through the state. Sometimes they're contracted through the state. And that's where things get kind of confusing because you'll hear me use the term licensing separate from your private agency or going directly through the state. So CPS themselves, if you're getting licensed through one or the other, licensing is kind of its own separate thing. So don't be surprised if it's not your agency coming in to license you. They may come in from time to time and also do walkthroughs. They may come in from time to time and also do kind of pre-interviews, but they're not usually the people that are going to come through and do a final licensing walkthrough or interview. And sometimes licensing isn't even the one coming through to do that interview. Once again, it could be a home study writer that is contracted through the state. So was all that confusing enough for you? I will say, don't worry too much about it. It's really on your agency to walk you through that and get all that set up for you. So don't let that information weigh you down. I just want you to be aware that 2 things are gonna happen. There will be some sort of interview. Whether there's one or several, it depends on your area, and there will be some sort of walkthrough. And once again, whether there's one or several, it's really up to your area. We've had agencies come and do pre-walkthroughs and walkthroughs several times. We've also had the home study writer walk through our house and look at everything. We've been in a state where licensing does a walkthrough, and the health department does a walkthrough, and the fire inspector does a walkthrough. So a little bit of overkill, but I promise they're not trying to make it hard for you. As always, I like to explain that the reason that areas do this is really they just want to make sure that homes are safe for their kids. So kind of the same with your interview process. You may get interviewed several times by your agency ahead of time as they prepare you and kind of take some of their own notes. You may have an interview only from licensing. You may have an interview that is just from your home study writer. So it really just depends on your area, and you may even have interviews from all 3. So you may have all 3 entities come and interview you. As far as what that looks like in your area for who gets interviewed, because that's a question I get a lot, like who are they gonna talk to? Are they gonna talk to just us grown-ups? Are they gonna talk to my big kids? Are they gonna talk to all my kids? Like, what does that look like? This is where I've seen it also vary from state to state. So usually every child I've had, as long as they can speak, they've been interviewed. Now, we've had it a few times where it's been the whole family around the table and we're kind of all just talking as one family unit. We've also had a situation where only the bigger, kind of older kids were pulled off to the side by the home study writer, but the rest of us and maybe the younger kids were sitting with mom and dad. And we've also had it where if you could talk, you were being pulled off to the side for a separate interview. I will say, as far as how to prepare for both the walkthrough and the interview portion, I may have a very different opinion than some people, so I really hope this doesn't rub everyone the wrong way. I don't think my opinion is like maybe an unpopular one. I just think that some people are really loud about their opinion and which way they would go, and I want you to understand there's 2 sides to everything. So I have heard foster parents say, when it comes to the walkthrough, don't stress about cleaning up. Just let them see your normal house. They know maybe you've already got kids, so they, oh, I know you already have kids, and they know you already have kids, and it's not that big of a deal. They understand when toys are everywhere. So I took a completely different approach. Like, we mopped everything. If you could like clean something, it was cleaned. If there was a donation pile, it left this house. If there was a laundry pile, it got washed, folded, and put away. We took a pretty intense approach. And the reason why was because in my mind, it was like a one-shot deal. And it's always great to make good first impressions. And then also, once again, it's not something they were expecting from me daily. It was a one-time thing. So I knew when they were coming, it wasn't a surprise. And so I just had my house ready. But that's my own philosophy on that. When it comes to the interview, I've also heard some foster parents kind of give the advice, don't prepare anybody for the foster parent. Be really organic, just kind of tell the truth and speak from the heart and that kind of thing. Listen, I am all about transparency. And the more you watch my videos, I hope you see that. I really love people to hear me speak from the heart. But when it comes to that interview, it was really important to me that my whole family was on the same page. And let me give you an example. So I'm former foster youth myself. myself. And there's a lot of experiences I've had in my life that my husband, of course, knows about. But we did sit down and pre-talk about it. Like, did you really understand how my mom passed away and how old I was? Because I didn't want it to sound like we were telling two different stories, knowing that we were going to be interviewed separately at some point. So I wanted to make sure that we were at least on the same page. And same with my kids. It wasn't like I was spilling my guts to tell them anything. I mean, with the little kids, most likely they're going to ask about day-to-day stuff. They may, in some states, they may ask, how do you discipline your children? And your children may be asked separate from you how you discipline them. So keep that in mind. Also, just kind of the day-to-day, do you feel safe? And what are your favorite activities? Those kind of things are going to be asked to your kids. So these are things we did talk about ahead of time. Have you thought about, like, what is your favorite activity? Do you, like, what do you like? Like, these are, we didn't have a script for them. We told them definitely, you know, have the freedom to say whatever you want to say, you know, but we did warn them ahead of time that these people were going to get a little bit invasive. They were going to ask some personal questions. And I know sometimes for me, I have a hard time being thoughtful, like on the spot, you know, like I need a little bit of a heads up. Like, am I going to have to get deep for a minute? Because if so, I like to know that ahead of time. So I kind of extended that to my whole family. And we did prepare a little bit for that interview. But once again, I know that my opinion isn't everybody's opinion. I think the camp is split like 50-50 on both. I think more typically I see people get very, very ready for a walkthrough and very, very ready for an interview. But once again, the information I have heard put out there is don't stress about either. And I will say, look, if you feel the need to stress about it and it kind of gives you a sense of calm, go for it. I mean, it's okay. It's a one-time deal. And also don't put that much pressure on it. If you are getting to the point of the process where they're doing a home study and they're doing a walkthrough, it's because they already think you're a good family. They already think you're a prime candidate to be a foster or adoptive parent. So these are kind of just the final steps in a lot of cases. So hopefully that makes you feel a little more free and a little more because once that piece is over, you can kind of wipe away the sweat and know that the next step is just being licensed and getting those calls. I hope that was good information for you all today. So let me know in the comment below, especially you already there foster parents, give some advice. Let us know, what was it like for you? What was that walkthrough like for you? What was that interview like for you and your family and in your state? Maybe because it's different from the ones that I've lived in. I would love to hear about it. And once again, in the series, I just want to say, if you are looking into foster care and adoption for the first time, let me tell you how excited I am for you. And I am cheering you on over here. I don't know you all by name. I don't know all your little faces, but I tell you what, I am over here just leaping with joy for how excited I am for you. It really is going to be great. You're going to do awesome. Don't you stress about that. And that's all the information I've got for today. So I'll see you later. We have had agencies walk through several times as kind of a pre-walkthrough. We have had the home study writer walk through and do their own walkthrough. I've said walkthrough a lot.